Okay, so the next person is Omer. I hope I pronounce it correctly. And you also say that you worked on a video game, so I assume that you want to be a video game artist. And you also want to have some feedback. And this is definitely something different than what I normally look at, so I have to adjust my eye just a little bit. But I think I can give you some feedback on this. You say your portfolio is mainly built from characters and they're stylized. So I guess that's also where you want to go. Looking at your portfolio, just glancing at it here, I can see that you have some more realistic stuff, more painterly stuff, and some really stylized fantasy stuff. So as I said earlier to our previous feedback, specialization versus generalization. So if I put your portfolio in here, I can sort of, if I'm the one hiring, because I'm also in that position, I'm an artist, but I'm also in the position of hiring in our company together with our producer. And we will say, for this project that we're now working on, we're working on a title called Castle Defense, and it's cartoony, and we need somebody who can do a cartoony style for mobile games. Okay, I'll find your stuff. And I'll say this also. These are quite good. But what about this? I don't need those. So who are you, by the way? And I don't need this as well, because that's something different. This as well. And this is painterly. This is like watercolor stuff. I definitely don't need that. So from a, if I'm like a very, very, like you, I'm just saying it, but all recruiters are thinking it and looking for it. You need to give a more coherent image of who you are and what can be expected of the work that you deliver. Because if you give an impression that you're on that you're a wild card, then the people looking at your portfolios won't know what they get. It's still within the same ballpark, I would say, so it's not a big problem. But if I was you, I would take your my portfolio and just specialize it just a bit more. That said, my own portfolio is still a mess, but that's me giving advice, it's not trying to give advice to myself, but I'm really thick-headed apparently. So let's just look at some of your stuff here, because I think a lot of, it's really nice. So hopefully I can just a little bit of icing on the cake. So for something, for example, like this. Yeah, it's really nice that you come with all these characters here. So that's really nice. One thing that is a little bit a shame that you miss out on this one. You could definitely go with, make sure that the silhouette of the characters is clear, because if it's for a mobile game, for example, you would look at a character on a very, very small screen. And if it's a 3D model, or 2D game or whatever it is, you really need to make sure that in a glance you can see what's going on, and even when the character is very small. So when they're this sketchy, the characters, it's a little bit difficult to figure out what's going on. But just maybe give it a general tone, because all these mushroom tentacles, they are really nice out here. They sort of get lost, and that's a shame, because you could definitely catch some of these and may use them for the silhouette. And I don't know what's going on with the hair, for example. I know it's sketches, but still you have a very good opportunity to sell some information here. So maybe just something like this. Just make it stand out a little bit more, like from the background. I think that would benefit like all your characters, just to make sure that everything is clear, because otherwise it just blends a little bit too much into the page. And then another thing is that when you put things up on a page like this, I would get rid of this, for example. I would take this, let me just merge everything. I would take this, put it down here, and then scale it up. I would make sure that everything here is presented very organized, like this. And definitely I would get away with this. Okay, take these away. If you want to show human size, like go in really and get a real human, drawing a real human. I'm drawing exactly the same stick figure as you, but as I'm saying, really go in and noodle in a real human, because this, you can do so much better than that. This just brings everything down. If you want to show scale reference, do it probably with a black silhouette of a real human in a pose, of course, so like standing with, I don't know, one arm to the side, arm down. Otherwise, you're just bringing the whole page down, and it would be a shame. So, but something like this, I mean, it shows that you have rendering skills and that you can paint. I mean, it's really nice. So I could definitely see a full page like that, but with rendered out style like that. That would be really powerful and really nice. And something like this, again, really nice. Do better with these characters, of course. Like, if you want to show characters, show them, just give it a little bit more love. But I mean, it's nice that you also give some ideas and suggestions. So organization and presentation, I think that you'll come a very long way with that. Because I mean, you have some really good painting skills. I'm not going that much into rendering, because there are certain things with rendering that could be done better in the pose. But in general, I think you'll benefit so much more from listening to other tutorials on YouTube on rendering. I'm not an expert on that. Yeah, more of that. So maybe let's just look at something that is a little bit out of that. So maybe some environment. Oh, this is nice. Oh, this is really good, actually. I mean, you're on a good track, I think. Especially like the brushwork here, that's much better than anything I can present. So I mean, that is really, really nice. So in general, there are some things with this, for example, with this image. When you look at this, it becomes very drawn, like with lines down here, and become very scribbly. So if you are doing this as you do here with these very big brush marks, you have them here, like these big swoops of brush marks, like that. When you then go in and do these very, very minute things, it's like you all of a sudden increase resolution here. And it looks a little bit off to me that there are so big strokes and empty areas. And then all of a sudden you have these very, very scribbly things down here. So I would see how I could generalize and paint my way out of like more just indicating that there's a person here. Maybe we don't need the face, or find a way to have the same kind of texel density. I think that's the word I'm looking for. So texel density in 3D mesh is how much space do you have between your, if it's a voxel-like unit, I guess it's called. So let me just try here. So right now it looks like the density on your character down there, it looks like this, like it's very, very high frequent, very, very noisy. While up here you have very, very broad strokes. So I think choosing some sort of minimum brush size that you would go with would greatly benefit how this is, how the final result looks. Because you have these very big swoops and strokes here. You get very scribbly also again here. And here it becomes bigger again. So I don't know, somewhere in between I think would be nice. But I think you could take it a little bit further and then start to really noodle a little bit more with this. Give this, I mean, if these are tattoos or indentation on this guy, maybe make some highlights on this. Really go to town on what you can do with this. I think that would be nice. But in general, this is really nice. I mean, it has this very nice story to it. This giant building this up here, I think that's really nice story to it. So just a little bit, pushing this a little bit more, as I said, trying to figure out the size of the breast that you're working with, the minimum size and stuff like that. That would be really nice. And you're doing such a great job with the edges here, like lost edges and firm edges like here. It's a bit of a shame that you have these, it looks more like accidents than real brush marks. Trying to figure out where you have the lost edges, like here maybe they just disappear. But while you're up here, they become much more firm. I think that would be nice to have this variation to it. Because you're doing it other places, and definitely here as well. So just make sure that it doesn't become too scribbly. I think it's also a matter of like when you have certain things that becomes too loose compared to something that you paint more strictly, then it's gonna drag down the image. And when you start to pull other things up, other things will fall down. So I think it's always a matter of a balance. But I mean, again, this is really, really nice. So I see that there's great potential for this. So just keep grinding. Let me just look at something like this. I think definitely other images becomes way too smudgy. It becomes very smudgy as well here. So this image stands out really strong. So in general, I mean, I cannot say that much for painting because I'm still very, very new at that. And that's something I have realized where my own weaknesses are, and that's something I'm working on right now to try to improve. So definitely I couldn't paint anything like this. I know what to do, but I don't know how to master it yet. So I can show you some of the work that I did here if we look at some of the concept work here. So like this is my painting from 2018, so that's 2 years ago, and that's not the same level as you do, but what I have been investing a lot of time in is trying to build a story into everything that I do. So for example, we did this Metro Exodus piece here, where this is an environment interior piece where the exterior is here. So this is based on like a ton of sketches and a ton of iteration and ideas and thoughts, like how should the exterior be and everything like that. So I believe that's where I put a lot of my eggs in the basket, is story and iteration and ideas, and then working on 3D. So I'm trying also myself to get back into more painting in 2D. But again, I consider everything to just be a tool for the end goal of conveying a story. So everything you look in here, that I have done in here, is like trying to build a story, trying to build something like coherent. So for example, here we made it like a Counter-Strike-ish level, and we tried to make everything as consistent as possible with the one team versus the other, the kids of the streets versus the robot army coming in. So all the design of the homemade versus the very robotic. So yeah, definitely, I mean, you show some really good notes here. Specialize, try to figure out where you want to go with this, and then I promise you, you'll see some really good results when you start to focus in your effort. Other than that, thank you for submitting your portfolio, and all the best of luck to you. I think this is the end. Unfortunately, we won't have time for the last one. I'm burning a little bit late here, I can see, so I think I will sign out for this session here, but it's been really great, and thank you for submitting portfolios, and looking forward to give some more feedback. Okay, see you guys.